This is Gqom. It's a difficult word for non-Zulus to say, but the music is amazing. It really hits you in the guts and I absolutely love it. I'm Emily Dust. I'm a DJ from London and I've been playing Gqom since I first heard it 4 years ago. We're going to be meeting the people behind the music. Most of the producers you'll hear from are now in their early 20s, but the story starts in their mid-teens with an explosion of young beatmakers experimenting on basic kit across the townships of Durban back in 2010. Club 101 in central Durban has been one of the most consistent supporters and influential clubs for Gqom music over the last 5 years.
When we started Gqom, we wasn't actually thinking we were starting a new genre, but then as people started to like our music, as we were pushing, it became more popular and popular. Now it's like worldwide, everyone is doing Gqom now. Around that time, they were actually listening to a lot of Devon Kwaito, Tribal House, Deep House. So we started with this new sound. It's more vibe-edge, a lot of drums. It's got a different rhythm. Devon has that raw sound, like Gqom, like that you can hear. This is the real Gqom.
If you are making the taxi kicks, use three steps, not like you usually house or usually come where they usually use four steps for make the kick to be strong for taxi.
When you feature the taxi for vibe,
they usually play the come. Even if you want to test the sound for your car or taxi. So you have to test the sound of come for vibe. Like before, most of our radio stations, they didn't want to play Gqom music because they are scared that the Gqom is, they will bend their speakers, see. Some of the producers, they don't master the Gqom beat, so it sound bad.
The two people who are really at the forefront of the kind of explosion of Gqom into the mainstream music are Distruction Boyz.
We started making music around 2012 together, so we were still in high school back then. So yeah, it's been like 6-7 years now.
We just want to thank God for everything He's done for us. I mean, because with what He's done for us, we've been able to take care of our families, you know. It's not just only about us. When we first released the album, we released a statement. We said we wanted to use our music as like a shining light, you know, as a stepping stone for a lot of other DJs and producers as well, so that when they get to where we are, they can be able to do the things that we're doing. So us making it, so to speak, has actually helped a lot of other individuals, I mean, family-wise and personally as well. When we first got into the industry, we had a plan. We were first to conquer Africa and then the world. We went to Namibia, we got an award. Went to Nigeria, we got an award. I feel like we came at the right time, you understand? When the industry was hungry for something new, you know? Something fresh, something edgy, something not diluted, something authentically African. We're happy about everything. I mean, we're really excited about the future.
Gqom is in very healthy shape. Outside of Durban, there are scenes popping up all over South Africa. There are artists like Shoma Josie propelling Gqom to new places by rapping in Swahili. And Pioneer's Rude Boyz told me they're planning to collaborate with UK rappers on their next album. Back in Durban, the local scene is as fertile as ever. There's huge demand for DJs every night of the week and hundreds of new tracks being produced every day.